In this video, I'd like to attract your attention to an important but somewhat overlooked topic of making the most out of your machine vision solution in terms of data storage, data processing, and to put it on a higher level, building business intelligence based on these data. We will start with the simple typical configuration: standard line 5 megapixel machine vision camera, one vision controller, and of course VisionMaster version 4.3. Then two more components have to be added. For persistent data storage, we will use MySQL database, and for data presentation, we will use Grafana, the popular tool used to analyze and visualize data. In both cases, we will use community editions running locally. VisionMaster is a great software for real-time image data acquisition and processing. It provides convenient features out of the box to put together operator's interface, allowing immediate monitoring of manufacturing process. However, built-in capabilities to store data persistently are limited to basic file storage functions, both for images and any extracted analytical data. This is exactly the gap we are going to bridge today. In our test scenario, we will perform a few typical tasks. We will count objects, pencils in our case, measure and categorize them. In a moment, we are going to check more details about the solution. But first, I want to jump ahead a little and show you more or less typical operator's UI for this task. Despite this kind of interface is sufficient for direct observation of the inspected objects, what if we want to get more information to receive broader overview of the process in our facility? For example, how many objects in different categories were inspected over the past shift, day or month? How does the distribution of our measurable metric look? How many items per batch we inspected most often, and so on? Additionally, if there are multiple inspection processes, it may be required to observe information about success rates in different inspection scenarios or in various visual algorithm flows. In this case, a dashboard like this may be of great help. I will not describe setup or initial configuration of MySQL or Grafana here. A lot of materials exist covering these topics, and details will vary depending on your environment. For my demo setup, I have used pre-configured virtual machines with these products. And, by the way, these virtual machines can be hosted on the Vision controller already in use. This is true for cases when inspection scenario is not too resource hungry and VisionMaster itself does not generate excessive load. Let's see how to build pipeline for the data originating from VisionMaster to be used on such a dashboard. First, we can review the structure of the solution to understand the underlying logic and identify the type of data it generates and outputs. As you can see, I am currently working with pre-configured image files captured by the camera earlier. This is simply to streamline the demonstration. The configuration and behavior with the live camera would be exactly the same. The objective is to detect each pencil within the field of view, measure its width and length, classify it based on width, and then determine whether the overall inspection passes by verifying that the total number of items falls within a predefined range. Once the image is introduced into the process via the image source module, it undergoes several pre-processing steps to prepare it for blob analysis, which is used to detect individual objects. The system then iterates over the results of the blob analysis using this group module, which functions as a loop. For each detected blob, two distance measurements are performed. This involves edge detection, followed by calculating distances between identified edges. Condition branch and format modules are used to convert width to category name. There will be two categories, normal and wide. All measurement results are stored in arrays, which serve as the output of the group module. Next, condition detection module verifies whether the number of detected pencils meets the expected criteria. Here's an important point. All data required in later stages of the process must be defined as output parameters of the procedure. These parameters should be given meaningful names. This will become important in the next steps. In the following stage, the relevant data must be transmitted from VisionMaster to a database. This requires retrieving the output parameters once the algorithmic flow execution is complete. How do we do that? There's awesome VisionMaster functionality, global script, and the integration will be implemented using C#. Let's quickly go through the code to clarify the logic behind it. This code is more or less universal and can be used without modifications in many cases. The main idea is to use callback function firing each time when any procedure working status changes. Procedure's output will be inspected and all data with the corresponding types will be pushed to the database. Results are collected every time a procedure finishes processing. Status receives a special treatment here. I want to use this field as an indicator of entire process execution, thus I want to put it separately. I also want to keep track of solution file names and paths. Let's see how the data are retrieved. We just iterate over all the variable names configured in the procedure's output and check their type, putting the data into our custom database structure. Here are a few methods to work with the database. One is used to establish and preserve connection, others to submit data in the corresponding tables. It is important to keep in mind that we must unregister our event processing function when the solution is closed, otherwise the registration will be kept, potentially causing unwanted and unexpected side effects. The last piece of the code is the definition of the class used as an intermediary container for the data. With this approach, there's no need to change the global script code if the metrics collected as procedure output require adjustment. To simplify the data submission to MySQL, I hooked up a library to support communication with the database. In this example, I'm using the MySQL connector /net version 9.1.0 maintained by Oracle, also known as MySQL.data, though there are other connectors. For example, MySQL connector provided with more permissive MIT license. Besides added dependency, you may have noticed imported types from the corresponding namespace in the very beginning of the code. Here's database structure for your reference. It is a simple one. There are separate tables for solution information and procedure status with timestamps and more universal table to store results coming out of procedure outputs. Depending on how you want to query data, you may want to add a few indexes for more efficient data retrieval. As you have already seen, we are processing only strings, integers, and floating point values in this example. Of course, in your scenario, other types can be added too. In case of multiple VisionMaster instances sending data to the same database concurrently, it may help to add one more field to the solution table for identification of the host where execution takes place. As the algorithm outputs new data, we can observe them populating the database with any compatible database management application. I prefer to use DBeaver due to its flexibility and convenience. After running the solution for a while, enough data is generated to see how they can be visualized and presented on the Grafana dashboard. Just one more remark. For long-term production deployment of the proposed model, it will be necessary to think of data retention policy and implement the mechanism to remove obsolete data, preventing service degradation. Now it's time to proceed with Grafana. We will see how to configure panels and monitor processing results. Grafana has to be configured to use the database containing collected data as a data source. Then, dashboard or multiple dashboards can be created with panels displaying aggregated data. Exact structure of the dashboard and type of widgets to be used greatly depends on the type of data to be generated by a specific application scenario. For our test case, we can come up with the following visualizations. Bar chart reflecting the number of successful and failed procedure runs plotted against time. Chart indicating number of items in each category. Another graph displaying average parameters of inspected objects and table with exact values of measured length. More general chart displaying processing speed can be used also. Let's see how one of these panels is configured. Preparation of the proper database query is the key to meaningful and useful data presentation. As we are aggregating data coming from the several tables, it may be more practical to use queries prepared with the editor instead of building them visually. Grafana provides high level of flexibility in many dimensions, and configuration of panel's visual appearance is no exception. Here is configuration of another panel. Configuration of dashboard and panels can include setting variables to improve user experience by making it more interactive and letting users explore data in greater detail without leaving the dashboard. Here you can see how the variable value is passed to the query to display the proper set of length values in the panel. In another panel, I have configured data links setting the value of this variable as URL parameter. Query results can be observed in a tabular form, a handy feature if you are in doubts about the values you see while refining your chart. Even though procedure ID value is not used in this panel's chart directly, it is used to link data in this panel with the data in the panel we inspected before. Ability to design such connections between panels to let users interactively work with the content is another extremely powerful feature of Grafana. Finally, let's see how acquired data can be monitored interactively with Grafana in real time. Indeed, operator can rely on runtime UI designed in VisionMaster, while Shift Supervisor, for example, can use Grafana for broader overview with a number of options to perform data analysis and see trends. Last but not least, with such a setup, it is possible to collect images by means of VisionMaster, store their handles in the database, and use Grafana as a user interface to access them. Of course, it will require additional component performing the file storage role. Still, it can be used as a quick and convenient way of delivering full-scale machine vision solution with appealing web-based user interface, analytical capabilities, role-based access rights management, and overall extraordinary versatility without the need to go through protracted, tedious, and expensive software development stage. On this positive tone, let me wish you a great day. Please do not hesitate to contact us with any questions or comments on this video, or in case if you have other relevant topics on your mind requiring clarification. Stay tuned for more videos on machine vision solutions by Hikrobot. Thank you for your attention.